डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू ईपीजी पाठशाला। दिस इज डॉक्टर ए जी सिन्हा, अ प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फिजियोथेरेपी, पंजाबी यूनिवर्सिटी पटियाला। वी शैल डिस्कस इन दिस मॉड्यूल द फिजियोलॉजिकल इफेक्ट्स ऑफ मसाज। मसाज मैन्यूवर्स इम्पार्ट मैकेनिकल एनर्जी टू द बॉडी। Depending on the technique of massage, the amount and duration of mechanical energy varies. It is the mechanical energy that produces effects on the various systems of the body. In the present module, we shall be talking about the effects of massage on different physiological systems of body. After going through this module, you shall be able to understand the physiological effects of massage, understand the mechanism of the effects, and you should also be able to learn to use the particular effect for therapeutic and restorative purposes. As I said earlier, the effect of massage is very much technique dependent. Therefore, the effect of superficial stroking is not the same as that of effleurage, because the amount of mechanical energy transmitted in these two procedures are different. Therefore, different techniques produce different effects on the body. In the present module, we shall talk about the effect of massage in general, the specific effects associated with individual techniques of massage are discussed in another module. During massage maneuvers, touch and pressure are applied to the body in the rhythmic manner. This produces basically two effects. The first pertains to the stimulation of sensory receptor present in the skin, whereas the second group of effects are the mechanical effects of massage, which are produced because of the pressure applied during massage. The compression of blood vessels and the lymphatics are the mechanical effects of massage. These effects can also be produced reflexly by the sensory stimulation. Therefore, when we talk about the effects of massage, we can broadly classify these effects into two categories. One, effects due to the stimulation of sensory receptors, and the second one are the effects produced because of the application of mechanical pressure. In addition to the physical and reflex effects, massage exerts strong psychological effects. Each of these effects produce a series of interrelated effects on the different systems of body. The effects of massage is more pronounced on the skin, on circulatory system, on nervous system, on the mobility of soft tissue, and also these effects are related to the metabolic systems. Massage exerts significant effect on the elasticity and mobility of the soft tissue. In order to understand the effect of massage on soft tissue, it is necessary to have a basic understanding on the structure of soft tissue. Soft tissues of the body are the ligament, muscle, capsule, tendon, and skin. These soft tissues can be broadly classified into two categories, contractile tissues and non-contractile tissue. Muscle is the contractile tissue because it has the inherent ability to produce contraction. On the other hand, the skin, ligament, tendon, capsules do not have the inherent property of contraction. Therefore, they are called non-contractile tissue. And the little amount of movement present in the soft tissue is necessary for smooth functioning of the locomotor system. Soft tissues are composed of minute collagen fibers that are loosely bound, and they are suspended over an amorphous ground substance called matrix. In fact, during voluntary movement, there occurs movement of soft tissue. Whenever a force is applied to soft tissue, minute movements of constituent collagen fibers also takes place. This small movement of soft tissue is essential for smooth execution of voluntary movement. Injuries and disease have negative effects on the mobility of soft tissue. Inflammation and early healing is characterized by presence of exudate. Exudate is a proteinaceous fluid that leaks out of the damaged capillaries. The tendency of the exudate is to coagulate. So if not removed in time, this exudate or proteinaceous fluid, it coagulates. And when this exudate coagulates, it binds the different constituent fibers of soft tissues and it restricts the movement of the soft tissue fibers. This binding of soft tissue to each other is known as adhesion, which gives rise to pain and restriction of range of motion of joint, and it is one of the most common cause of pain and dysfunction that persists long after the healing of injury takes place. The same phenomena occurs during disuse. When a part is not moved for a long time, the constituent collagen fibers of soft tissue get stuck to each other. Massage techniques apply a passive force on the soft tissue of body and move them in various directions. The to and fro movement of different massage maneuvers rolls the individual fibers of the soft tissue and mechanically breaks down the adhesion, and this facilitates the free movement of the adherent structure. This makes massage a powerful therapeutic tool in all the conditions where restriction of soft tissue mobility due to injury, disease, or disuse becomes the cause of pain and dysfunction. Massage facilitates the movement of skin over underlying structure. As a result, skin becomes soft, pliable, and supple. The dead cells of skin are removed by movement of hand over skin. This makes the sweat gland and sebaceous gland free from obstruction and allows them to function more effectively. The improved function of sweat and sebaceous gland improves the lubrication and appearance of skin. Massage with various oils is a common practice. It is believed that massage by various medicinal oils has some curative values in certain diseases, and therefore the prescription of massage with medicinal oils is a common practice in Indian medicinal systems. Oil massage enhances the penetration of medicinal molecules into the skin. It is a common observation that rubbing vigorously makes the part warm and red. This warmth and redness is due to improved blood flow to the rubbed area. As a result of rubbing, the capillaries and arterioles get dilated and filled with blood, which is responsible for raising the temperature of the area and making it red. This observation led to the widespread belief by the practitioner of massage as well as by the layman that massage improves the blood supply of the area. The circulatory system consists of three main channels of blood flow: arterial system, venous system, and lymphatic system. Arterial system brings fresh blood from the heart to the periphery, whereas the venous system takes the impure blood to the heart from the periphery. The lymphatic system is an accessory route for the large molecule protein particles. These particles do not get entry into the venous system and are removed from the area by the lymphatic system. Veins and lymphatic vessels have valves which does not allow the back flow of the blood. The arteries do not have valves. The effects of massage is more pronounced on the venous and lymphatic systems. Massage facilitates emptying of venous and lymphatic vessels and improves the venous and lymphatic drainage. Massage maneuvers alternately compress and release the soft tissue. This mechanical compression resembles with the normal muscle contraction and contributes to increase the pressure on a venous and lymphatic segment, and this facilitates opening up of the valve so that the blood and lymph moves into the next segment. This way, massage facilitates the forward movement of venous blood and lymph and aids in the mechanical emptying of veins and lymphatics. Improved venous and lymphatic flow reduces the stagnation of fluid in soft tissue and speeds up removal of waste product. This effect of massage is used in the treatment of swelling following dysfunction of venous and lymphatic vessels. During inactivity and paralysis, the muscle pumping action on vessels is lost. This gives rise to swelling. Massage in these situations serve as an important substitute of muscle activity as far as the venous and lymphatic drainage is concerned. Massage also improves arterial flow. The increase in arterial flow during massage is attributed to the release of vasodilator substances, reflex action, and also as a result of reduction in venous congestion. Increased arterial blood flow brings more oxygen and nutritive element to the area massaged. These effects are believed to accelerate the rate of metabolic exchange. The accelerated blood flow after massage is one of the reasons for using massage after exhaustive workouts. It is usually believed that by increasing the blood flow to the area, the accumulated waste products such as lactic acid can be removed from the massaged area and this will rejuvenate the body parts. However, research evidence do not entirely support this view. There is a strong research evidence for the improved venous and lymphatic drainage following massage application. But the evidence for the improved arterial blood flow is equivocal. Some studies have demonstrated that massage improves the arterial blood flow of the skin. But these studies have failed to show the increase in muscle blood flow following massage. Another mechanical effects of massage is its effects on the respiratory systems. The techniques of percussion and vibration helps in dislodging thick viscid secretion from lung and assists in removal of respiratory secretions. After removal of secretion, gas exchange becomes more efficient and the oxygen content of blood increases. However, it should be noted that effects of massage on respiratory systems are produced by the specialized technique that should only be administered by a well-trained practitioner. Massage stimulates sensory receptor present in the skin. The different maneuvers of massage imparts an array of sensory experience by stimulating peripheral touch and pressure receptors present in skin and soft tissue. This stimulation of sensory receptors generate an electric impulse. This electric impulse travels through the nerve fiber to the spinal cord and brain and produce a variety of effects on the sensory, motor, and autonomic nervous system. Nervous system composed of three components: motor system, sensory system, and autonomic systems. Sensory systems consists of different sensory receptors and sensory nerve fibers. द फंक्शन ऑफ द सेंसरी रिसेप्टर इज टू कलेक्ट द इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट द वेरियस एक्टिविटीज गोइंग ऑन इन द बॉडी एंड कन्वे इट टू द ब्रेन थ्रू सेंसरी नर्व फाइबर्स. द वर्क ऑफ मोटर सिस्टम इज टू जेनरेट द कमांड फॉर मोटर एक्शन. इट इज थ्रू मोटर सिस्टम द ब्रेन जेनरेट्स कमांड एंड प्रोड्यूस एंड कंट्रोल द मूवमेंट्स ऑफ डिफरेंट पार्ट्स ऑफ द बॉडी. द ऑटोनोमिक नर्वस सिस्टम regulate those activities that are not in our conscious control. These activities are heart rate, blood pressure, respiratory rate, temperature of the skin, and so on and so forth. It is believed that at some level there is an integration of all these three systems. It is believed that sensory stimulation can potentially affect the motor system as well as autonomic nervous system. Now we shall discuss one by one the effects of massage on each of these three systems. On sensory system, the main effect of massage is sedation and perception of well-being. The use of massage for pain relief is an age-old practice. However, the exact mechanism by which massage may reduce the pain was not known until Melgick and Wall put forward their famous pain gate theory in 1965. This theory provided a rationalized scientific explanation for the pain relief produced by massage and the other procedures that use sensation as a means of pain relief. The pain gate theory held that like touch, pressure, heat and cold, pain is also a sensory stimulus that travels through sensory nerves to brain via spinal cord. Unless an impulse reaches the corresponding area of brain, the sensation is not felt. Therefore, feeling the sensation of touch, pain and pressure, the electrical impulses of these sensations must reach the brain. The speed of transmission of these three sensory stimuli varies. While the touch and pressure travels at a faster pace, the stimulus of pain travels at a relatively slower pace. When applied together, the impulses that travels at a faster pace reaches the spinal cord early and blocks the path of other impulses that reaches there afterwards. Therefore, application of other stimulus in presence of pain blocks the upward travel of pain impulse and provides pain relief. The second part of this theory relates to the response of brain to the painful stimulus. When a painful stimulus reaches to brain, the certain areas of brain releases some chemical substances. These chemical substances have anti-pain properties. These are known as endogenous opiates. They produce pain relief and a feeling of well-being. The pain gate theory explained the pain relieving and well-being effect associated with massage techniques. Massage maneuvers stimulates deep and superficial interoceptors, proprioceptors in tendon and muscles, and interoceptors present in the deep tissue and organ. These sensory impulses are carried by large diameter A-beta fibers to the spinal cord. The light massage techniques such as effleurage, stroking and kneading apply sensation of touch and pressure that competes with pain sensation and blocks their upward transmission, leading to pain relief. On the other hand, deep massage techniques such as friction and deep kneading, they produce mild to moderate discomfort and stimulate the secretion of endogenous opiates. Effects of massage on motor system confines to regulation of muscle tone, which is a reflex phenomena affected by changes in central and peripheral nervous system. Muscle tone is the state of preparedness of muscle for contraction. A low muscle tone is indicative of poor contractile ability. where a relatively higher degree of stimulation is required to produce contraction in the muscle, whereas the high tone indicates that a muscle requires very less stimulation for contraction. The muscle tone can be modulated by peripheral sensations. The effect of massage on muscle tone is the reflex effect that results from stimulation of sensory receptors, and it may be mediated through the spinal motor neuron excitability. It is the spinal center that sends facilitatory or inhibitory signals to the muscles. Spinal center itself receives facilitatory and inhibitory signals from higher center of brain as well as from the periphery. The sensory signals generated by the stimulation of receptors may influence the excitability of spinal motor neuron and affect the muscle tone. Massage exerts both facilitatory and inhibitory effects on the motor fibers. Some massage techniques are shown to increase the muscle tone, whereas other reduces the muscle tone. These seemingly paradoxical effects are believed to be due to stimulation of different receptors. Some massage techniques increases the muscle tone by stretching the muscle spindle or stimulating the superficial exteroceptor. The superficial techniques of massage, such as tapping, hacking, superficial stroking, are believed to increase the muscle tone. Pressure on the muscle belly stretches the muscle fibers and stimulates the muscle spindle, which excites the motor neuron pool. On the other hand, petrissage and kneading techniques are believed to reduce the tone of muscle by application of heavy pressure. It is postulated that the application of deep pressure during these techniques activates the tension-dependent Golgi tendon organ that has an inhibitory effect on the reflex stretch mechanism. Reduction of muscle tone contributes to relaxation and forms the basis of using massage in conditions associated with increased muscle tone, such as muscular spasm, pre-competitive anxiety, etc. On the other hand, increase in muscle tone may bring about increased preparedness of muscle for contraction. The effect of massage on autonomic system is also mediated through reflex action. It is hypothesized that sensory stimulation of massage may evoke a variety of autonomic reflexes. These effects can influence the functioning of visceral organs. This is the basis of using massage techniques in reflexology. Physiological responses associated with autonomic nervous system, such as heart rate, respiratory rate, blood pressure, skin temperature, skin resistance, activity of sweat gland, are claimed to be affected by massage. Increased vagal activity resulting in lowering psychosomatic arousal and level of stress hormones are postulated as some of the possible mechanism for this effect. But the scientific evidences on these effects are not conclusive. Some studies have shown a change in the autonomic parameter, whereas other studies have not shown any change in these parameters. Most of the studies on the effects of massage suffers from serious methodological flaws. Massage exerts a strong placebo effect. Touching a person communicates an intention to heal, share energy, and promote relaxation. The importance of touch in communication and imparting a sense of well-being and confidence is always recognized. Massage is known to reduce anxiety and tension and induce relaxation. This effect is more pronounced when massage is used for the purpose of general relaxation. Studies consistently support that massage enhances the perception of well-being and relaxation. The psychological parameters associated with stress and anxiety has been shown to reduce after massage. This makes massage a powerful non-pharmacological agent in stress-relieving strategy. The ambience of massage, way of communication of massage operator and the assured way of handling can induce strong placebo effects that helps to allay anxiety and induce comfort. The effects of massage on psyche are hypothesized to generate a number of favorable autonomic and immunological responses. It is now established that stress reduction contributes favorably in many psychosomatic conditions. It is also claimed that massage improves the functioning of immune system. Research reports have supported the assumptions that regular massage of a child with oil help improve the growth and development and enhance the ability to fight infection. Many claims on the effects of massage are difficult to validate in rigorously designed scientific studies, and many claims of the effects of massage remains unproved. However, massage remains one of the methods that have been found useful by the practitioner and the users. Massage is capable of enhancing the strength of muscle is the most common belief. However, massage may improve the circulation of the muscle. It accelerates the removal of the waste product, and thereby it may prepare a ground for better contraction of muscle. But the ultimate increase in the strength of muscle is the result of muscle contraction. If a sports person does not perform exercise, rather active exercise, and only relies on massage, then his muscle strength will not increase. A similar myth exists with regard to the role of massage in fat reduction. It is claimed that massage promotes lipolysis and it can enhance the burning of fat. And this is the basis of using massage in various weight reduction programs where the various kind of vibratory belts are used to impart the mechanical energy of massage maneuvers. However, scientific evidence does not support this view. Obesity is a condition of positive energy balance. It results from consumption of higher energy and inactivity leading to reduced energy expenditure. Massage at best can prepare a muscle for contraction and it can make the exercises little bit more tolerable by its effect on the pain and relaxation. Massage at best can be used as an adjunct to the weight reduction program for lessening the fatigue associated with heavy workout. Ultimately, it is the intensity of active workout that contributes to the reduction of fat, not the passive massage procedures. Thank you.